Hey guys, this is Simon with Trade and Perform Coaching. Wanted to do a trade review for Tuesday's trading. Today's the 20th of April, 2020. I'm going to try to keep this to under 15 minutes, and hopefully I can do that. Before I get started, if you'll just read this legal notice real quick, it basically says past performance is not indicative of future results. I am simply sharing my trade plan with you that hopes that makes you a better trader. Please don't follow me blindly. I'm here to teach and help other traders. I'm not a guru, just not a guru, right? I'm a guy trying to make a couple of bucks. I think I have a process that works really well that I can teach other people, right? But this is not for you to come in. I'm not trying to turn anyone into a millionaire. That's your job, not mine. My job is to teach you how to do it, right? You have to have the perseverance, the desire, the ability to learn, and the patience to set up the best trades. I try to teach the best trades, but you have to be the one that executes, right? You have to be able to control yourself and execute really, 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 really well. Okay, so let's get started so I can go play with my kids. It's 3:42 now that we've taken care of that stuff. So every day we start off from this two levels. We look at the hourly levels, but we also look at the day time frame, right? And there's some important areas of the day time frame. Number one, I want to know, can we get above the prior day's high and then close back in? That's always indicative of a potential trap, right? And for those who are new to the process, we're doing two things. We're looking at these big levels, and I'll get to this in a second, but then we're going to the algorithm, and we're getting to these really small levels on this chart, which is, imagine a microscope where we're zooming in and we're zooming out. We're zooming in, zooming out to find the best setups, because the secrets to the setups are in the tiny details, right? But the areas are on the large details. So I'm going to cover that for you here real quick, okay? So number one, when we look at the profile, we know we traded above the prior day's high. When we look at the profile, there are some areas we don't want to trade in. We don't want to trade inside, I'm going to mark this off, prior day's points of control. That's both TPO and volume. It is simply the choppiest place. It is simply the choppiest place in this entire profile. And you can see from how this day developed, we traded above it, we traded below it, and we traded straight through it. And as long as you initiated outside of this area, you probably did okay. Long up top, short down bottom, and you probably did okay. The yellow areas and the white areas are important areas to look for potential reversals, right? So we only had one yellow area to look for potential reversal, and that was 28.56 and a quarter, and it marked the low of the day, right? We didn't have one on top unless we trapped back in below 28.81. My eyesight's going on me as I get older here. So I guess when you're doing it for 25 plus years, your eyes wear on you a little bit looking at these screens. So next thing, right? Okay, so now we have an important area, right? We know it's a good area, right? We know those are good areas. So we know we want to be, and then one last piece. The blue, the value area, is one area we want to be outside of if we can help it initiating trades. Inside, we want to be very reserved or not trade at all inside the prior balance area. Occasionally that bites us, but usually, like you'll see today, all the best entries came just below the blue value area. And if you want to learn more about that, you don't have to come to me. I'm happy to teach it. But that's In Mind Over Markets by Dalton, or there's Markets in Profile. I forget the guy, the gentleman's name who wrote the book, but those are the two books I'd recommend if you want to use Profile. It's a backbone. So we spent enough time on that. Let's jump to the good stuff. So basically on this chart, what we knew is 28.81.50 was an important area. In addition, and so that chart, wait a minute, so what that chart translates into is this 5-minute chart. And that's really cool, because what you see is if you just focused on the yellow zone, you had some really great trading opportunities today, right? I don't take these blindly. They need to set up for me. But those were the locations where I wanted to trade. A trap back in on 28.81.50. And then if it set up up here, great. But if it didn't, that was okay too, right? What you'll also see here that was really important was the London low. We really wanted to see how we were trading around London low. And that's that orange line. And that was the other area that was incredibly important for a potential trap, because all the stops from London all overnight, all those stops had to be sitting right here in stops. It's important that you know where they are, because you always see that complaint from retail traders, right? They took my stops out and then it went up. And those from people who bought early, right? And they get stopped out over here. They bought overnight. We take all the stops, then we bounce it back in. The other place you see people complain is they go, oh, well, I took it at the prior day's point of control, and it was really choppy. Whether you were short or long, you can see how we just all night long, sometimes we reject out of this area, sometimes we hold on the backside test, sometimes we fall straight through. And all that means is it's a 50-50 area for almost anything you do. You just flip a coin. That's as good as it gets. And what we want is to push towards 60, 70, and 80% setups where we know we have a very high win rate, right? And we're very, very structured in how we're taking those trades. And if you followed that basic core idea of the room, right? Look for the yellow zones, stay out of the blue dashed areas and the weak blue zones and focus on the yellow zones. You usually end up with a pretty darn good trade if you focused your trades in those areas. But we want to take it a step further, and that's what I wanted to show you now, right? So if you look, this was Globex High. And the first place, one of the first places we were looking to short setup is if we could have gotten above London High, Globex High, and we just couldn't get up there. I would have loved to have a short. But I also mentioned that we look at the hourly chart. And I'm going to show you the chart we had set up from this morning. Let's scoot this over to the other monitor. Right? And what I want everyone, if you can visualize the idea of these, you ever see those Russian dolls where the dolls inside the doll are, you know, the clown car where the clown keeps getting out? All of this is kind of stacked on top of each other. And understanding the concept of the time frames, one feeding off the other, really, 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 really helps. Right? So down here, let's get rid of this chart. Down here, you will see that we had some levels marked off from prior day. And these yellow areas were areas where I was looking for potential shorts, regardless really of where we had traded overnight, right? So 2912 was an area. You see, we just got over it, it fell apart. You can see that we came right to the 2881.50, right? And this was key. So these are coming off the hourly chart, these support resistance levels, not off the profile, right? So we're merging the two. And so when we're down here, these levels were posted the prior day, right? So when we get over this level, let's say, I'm looking for shorts to set up on that really tiny time frame that I'll show you in a minute. When we get above this level, same thing. When I get above this level, same thing. I want to see set up on a very micro time frame. And then what I want to do is switch from the micro to the macro, meaning the large time frame, so I can see where that trade can go. And that's how, as a day trader, you turn a scalp into a swing and have the potential to make a lot of money. And you don't have to hit a lot of these to have some really killer days, right? Because you need a little bit of luck to get all the pieces to come together at one time. And usually, anywhere from 2 to 3 times a week, we get one that comes together, one or two trades that will come together really big. And the rest of them, we're just paying the bills with, right? Anywhere from 2 to 10 points a trade. And then we're trying to get one decent, really big one, or two decent, really big ones every week, right? Because they have to fit our time frame. It has to fit all the pieces that we're looking for in our process. And now I'm going to show you the trades that we took and one that we didn't take today, even though we wanted it. So I wanted the short up here, number one, but that hit like at 5 in the morning. And I'll show you what that looked like. So that short at 5 in the morning, when we came up here, if you look, we're looking for a couple of things on this level, right? So I'm going from a very big chart to this is a 2-range bar. And then I'm using Wyckoff waves to figure out the balance of power, right? And what I want to do is identify where there's sellers and buyers. And I want to identify patterns like what we call energy zones that get built. They're based on these numbers that you see above and below. We're looking for energy bars. And then we're also looking for head and shoulders and failed head and shoulders. So there's a couple of patterns, and they're not that hard to learn. So if you were looking up here, for example, you would say this is the head. This is the left shoulder, all right? And you can see that we tested right up into that left shoulder and rolled over. Unfortunately, I also have a rule that says that I don't trade prior to 9 o'clock because it tends to be pretty damn hard. And we saw the trade, we just didn't take the trade. That's all there is to it. But there's other pieces in here that can be learned, right? So remember, we have this 2912 sitting up here, and we know that's a really important level from our hourly chart, right? And if you look, I believe, let me look before I misspeak, we also form what's called an energy box here. So you have a 93, 12, 24, 6. You want any three ascending or descending, both on top and below. So here you get a 130, a 77, and a 21. And then you get a 26, a 12, and a 37, right? Again, normally what I would do, so the box is that 37 and that 21 right there. So let's pause, time out for a second. We have multiple things going on. We're at an hourly level. We're way, 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 way stretched overnight. Inventory is long overnight, meaning that we're at the high and they've been pushing it, right? They've been pushing it. And we're coming up there and we're looking to trap buyers, right? And I'm not going to go through all the pieces that are there, but that energy box that I highlighted in yellow is very important. If I close below it, right, I simply don't want to close with a positive. So realize it didn't set till this 37, right? So I want to make sure everyone sees that. The setting numbers are this 21 and this 37. So this doesn't count over here, right? So normally what I would do in this setup, even if I didn't have everything else that I have back here, I would simply short this bar right here, that 2900 bar. I would short it with abandon. Those are big. When the algos trigger on these energy boxes, they produce big trades. Here, we can cheat and show you what it did, right? So you can see that because of my 9 a.m. rule, I didn't get the trade. So then if you come back in here and you'll see when we're running the room, we have a great team of traders in the room, right? And we're all going back and forth sharing ideas. Some of us are learning. Some of us have a ton of experience, right? And we're sharing those ideas together so that we can all get into the same location, right? And what we're trying to do here, let me see if I put it down, and we are, did not write it down, but I can promise you, we wanted a short right there. I think I was at 2901 for the short. I wanted a backside test right into this level for the roll to the downside. Now, let me pause for just a second. That is not a bad thing, right? Let me tell you why. We had the right setup. I didn't break my no trading prior to 9 a.m. rule, which keeps me safe a great deal of the time, right? I placed the limit for the entry at the right location, and the trade worked. The only problem is I didn't get filled, right? And that's okay, because I know if I get 100 shots like that, that about 75 will fill, 25 won't, the rest is a shoulder shrug, and I'm on process. And I told everyone in the room, hey, we didn't get filled, we're not chasing, we'll probably get set up on the long side, and we did. So if you'll look, it sucked not to get filled because it was a huge roll down and the market traveled right down to the yellow zone that we're focusing on right there at 2856, right? So I'm going to go over here to 2856 and cheat and show you where we got our long today. We took down, 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 and there was our entry right over here. So you can see, I'm pretty sure I did write this one down, so I'm going to go look. There we go. So at 10.04 a.m., I put long ES 2861, adding 2860, stop 2853.50. So my risk was going to be roughly 2860.5. So it's going to be about 7 points of stop, right? And so that's where we put down the trade for this morning. So I can get this out of the way. There we are. And let me show you what set that up. So we're watching when it comes up, and we know we're into that yellow zone right down here at the top of 2856. Here, I'll draw a line on that, all right? So that's 2856 right there. We already know that we have potential location, but we don't want to take the trade blindly. Why? Because that's about a 60% win rate by itself. And even though it worked perfectly this time, it doesn't always work perfectly, right? And what we're trying to do, the key to making a lot of money trading, whatever that lot of money means to you, is finding really great setups and then polishing off the smooth edges, learning, right, circles within circles, as one of my favorite authors, who I cannot bring up to mind because I'm speaking live, talks about it. But it's from the book, The Art of Learning. And he talks about making circles within circles, learning little nuance, right? So if we look, there's a couple of issues with it. First of all, we can't get a left shoulder if we're looking for a head and shoulders over here to all the way over here. And there's not an inverted head and shoulders to take up to the left side. So the next thing that we start to look for is there a potential, energy box, right? So we're going to look as we're coming down. We get a 48, a 57, and a 104. Those are three ascending numbers there. Now I need something matching underneath. And I get a 75. 21 and a negative 103. So now I have an energy box that basically goes really, I'll draw it here. to here. All right. So I'm going to put some more lines on this chart because I love mucking up my charts. And that means I have an energy bar from 5750 to 2854. And this, remember, is the dashed line. That is the beginning of my zone off the daily chart, right? So see how we're stacking day time frame, stretch, trade location, right? And I can see I'm at 1528, so I'm going to try and finish it up because you can already see the trade work, right? So we get long at 2860. So the reason why, and I could have been a little bit earlier when I recollected, when I went back on this trade, I actually should have been long at 2859, full boat. So I goofed the trade slightly, not horribly, right? And then the target was, if you look, so what we had to contend with here was the point of control. That was the target up, was 2865 to 2871 had to be the initial target, and then see if the trade would run. There was two things going on here that were causing this issue. First was London closed. That one I wasn't so worried about. But New York lunch can really suck. It can be chop fill. And I don't like trading through it. So this is where I end up getting long, is right in here. I was a little bit late on the trade. Not a lot. I should have done better on that. I'll improve on it tomorrow, right? So we're long here. The first target is 2865 and change. I believe we got 2865.50. Let's go look. What I did, because I wrote it down, I take the trades. So I scale 2865, not one-to-one, but it's the point of control and has to be respected, right? And then I said 2870 was the next scale down to a quarter size and pending. I actually scaled, I think, at 2869 and a half. I came out just a hair early. And that would have been right, this is what we were shooting for. We came right to the ask and missed it. I think I got it out right there. Took it down to quarter size. And then here's where I made my mistake. I moved my stop up because of the time of day in London. I was afraid we would sweep through. And they came out and took me out break even on the last quarter of that trade. But eventually, based on where we took it, that trade had the potential of being worth 15 points, right? Which is pretty damn good. Okay. So I wanted to go through what the anatomy of the trade looked like when we're looking for longs and shorts. What we demonstrated here is we set up the trade locations from a larger time frame to a smaller time frame. B, we had our location and we used discipline. Sucks that we didn't catch the short, but great that our setups work. We just need a little bit of love from the market sometimes to get filled, and we didn't. And then we did the cool thing. Instead of chasing or getting mad or pissed off or frustrated, we just wait until they come to the other side of the range and take them the other way, right? That was a totally acceptable thing to do. And we closed that out. I was all done before lunch, and that was my last trade of the day there because it just didn't set up the way I wanted it to the rest of the day. Here's the point. In the room, we're trading with structure and discipline. We know exactly what we're looking for, and we need a little bit of luck to get the fills, right? But we know what our risk is. We know how to press when the market's pressable, and we know when to pull back when the market isn't pressable. And here's the important thing about that. It won't always work. It doesn't always work, right? Sometimes there are stops. But when you have this kind of, when we have the algos working from us, we have the understanding of the profile charts, plus the hourly time frame, and we know where the stops are and when those are getting taken out, and then what those patterns look like when you're getting failure at those locations, there's a lot of money on the table, and it's our goal in the room to capture that money the best we can. So we don't always do it perfectly. Again, I'm not a guru, but we have a really great process. Lastly, if you would like to visit the room, so first of all, the room's not cheap, okay? It's $195 a month, so a lot of people are just going to be like, screw that, I'm not paying to be in the room, and I'm fine with that, don't care. But for those who would like to be in the room, it's $195 a month, including the software, okay? Number two issue is if you'd like to visit the room, send me an email. My name is Simon, and the email is trade, TRADEN, like the letter Nancy, N as in Nancy, perform, PERFORM, @gmail.com. You're welcome to have a 5-day visit into the room. You don't have to put down a credit card or anything else. I do strictly enforce the 5 days, however. You're welcome to come visit us, learn a little bit from us. If you don't learn from me, learn from someone, or you will pay Mr. Market a boatload of tuition, and find someone who fits your personality type and has a process you can understand, and then invest in taking the time to learn it, understand it, and work with that person so they can help you along if they're legit, right? And I realize it's hard to tell who's legit and who's not, but that's another story. Anyways, I failed on my time limit. It's at 1959. I hope everyone has a great day. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to me. I'm happy to answer them. Don't ask me what the algo, how it's generated, because I'm not going to share it with you. I worked for years and years and years to make that thing work, and I have no desire to tell anybody how it works. But I'm happy to share it. Anyways, have a great night, guys, and I will see everyone bright and early tomorrow's Fed Day, so probably tons of fun on tap. We'll see you guys.